Power, if I stand too far away. some lumber. If there were a bride and groom here, who'd there be?
Well, there might.
We shall see. When we come to an agreement, as my lovey dovey, chubby, coochie lover, chubby, hubby.
I shall scream,
I shall scream,
Mom.
Black hat. Oh, gosh, what? Give a boy a top hat. These things must be done proper and correct. Now there, that coffee boy.
Thank you. dear.
13, sir.
Then I'll whop you on when I get in. You just see a bit of your little workhouse rat.
Did you knock, sir?
I kicked.
Did you want a coffin, sir?
No, but you'll be wanting one before long if you stop cheeking your superior. You don't know who I am, I suppose. Workhouse.
No, sir. I can't say as I do.
I'm Mr. Noah Claypole, and you're under me. You are, young scallywag.
Hello, Noah.
Do you hear a workout?
No, Noah. What a tease you are. Let the boy alone.
Let him alone? I'm just giving the boy a change, you silly thing. Everyone left him alone. His father left him alone. His mother left him alone. They all left him alone, except dear old, kind old Noah. Hey, Charlotte?
You are a one.
Workhouse? How's your mother?
You leave my mother out of this. She's dead.
What did she die of, workhouse? Shortage of breath?
Never you mind.
Oh, but I do mind.
Well, you better not say any more, see?
Better not if you don't mind. The cheek of it. The workhouse cheek of it. My mother, he said. She was a nice one, she was. You know, workhouse, it can't be helped now. And of course, it could be her best. And I'm very sorry for it and all that. But you must know, workhouse, your mother was a regular right down ballad.
What did you say?
A regular right down ballad. And it's a good thing she died when she did, as she's been doing hard labor in prison. As like as not. Miss Granny! Charlotte! Listen! This Indian boy's murdering me! Help! Help! He's gone mad! Charlotte!
What's up? Ah! What happened to you?
Meet, madam, meet!
Oh. hungry for Moisin. Hungry?
Starving.
Got no mother?
No.
Father?
No.
Lovely bone.
My, what do I have to buy? Don't you think? Stay in London?
Yes.
Got any lodgings?
No.
Money?
Not a farthing.
London?
When I'm at home.
I suppose you want some place to sleep tonight, don't you? Are you accommodated?
No, I don't think so.
Then accommodated you should be, me old mate. There's a certain house, and I know a respectable old gentleman what lives there, what'll give you lodgings for nothing, and never ask for the change. That is, if any other gentleman he knows introduces you. And does he know me? I should say he does. Not half an old dead son.
Who is this respectable gentleman then? Is he a charity gentleman?
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that. Not exactly. But if I introduce someone, it's all right. On account of I happen to be a particular favourite of Mr. Fagan. That's his name, Mr. Fagan. By the way, if I'm introducing you to Fagan, I better know who you are, me old China plate.
My name's Oliver. Oliver Twist.
And my name's Jack Dawkins, better known among me more intimate friends as the Artful Dodger.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Dawkins.
Come to think of it, I ain't got no intimate friends. Still, what's the difference, me old pork sausage? You're coming with me.
Are you sure Mr. Fagan won't mind?
Mind? Come, city yourself. At home. Come, city yourself. One of the family, we've taken to you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares?
more.
Fagan, this is my new friend, Oliver Twist.
I have the honour of your intimate acquaintance. Leave him alone! We're all very delighted to see you, Oliver. Very. Charlie, draw the tub near the fire for Oliver. Dodger, take off them sausages.
They're stale.
Shut up and drink your tea. Oh, you're a staring at the fucking handkerchiefs, eh, my dear? There are quite a few of them, ain't there? We just hung him out, ready for the wash. The wash! That's all, Oliver. That's all. Well, not exactly, my boy. I suppose the laundry would be a very nice thing indeed. But our line of business pays a little better, don't it, boys?
No!
You see, Oliver, in this life, wanting comes in the bank, the largest sum. I'm afraid he don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two.
You've got to pick a pocket or two.
to pick a pocket or two.
You have to find something so fine.
You have to pick a pocket or two.
Put them all back in the box. They might be. Very ingenious work, that, ain't you, Oliver?
Very ingenious, sir.
And what have you got, Charlie?
Nose rods.
They're very nice ones. Yellow and green. You haven't embroidered them too well, though, Charlie. So we'll have to kick the initials out with a needle. You need to learn how to do this too, Oliver. Rosie boys.
Yeah,
but in the meantime, you need to learn how to make work, like Dodger and Charlie here. Make him your mother. Especially Dodger. He's going to be a right regular bill sight. Now then, is my pocket handkerchief protruding from my pocket?
Yes, sir. I can just see it.
See if you can take it out without my noticing it. Like you saw the other two.
Pum 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 pum
gone?
Yes, sir. It's in my hand.
Is it? What a clever boy. I never saw a sharper lad. Here's sixpence for you. I've got to go to the bank. You go on this way, my lad. You shall be the greatest man of all time. Yes, you're quite a gentleman now. You've got a home of your own and a profession, eh, boys?
Yes, sir.
Now, better on all of you. There's a hard day's work ahead of you tomorrow.
Oliver, you can keep the hungry.
Sit down now, Dodger. Take your hammer off and bed.
Thank you.
noisy in house. But I can't help it. I just love to look at it. This is my pleasure. A cup of coffee. And a quick candle. I mean, who's going to look after me in my old age? Will you, Bertie? Will you? No!
Why are you awake? What does this mean? Quick, quick, speak! I want to hear every detail you saw.
I couldn't sleep anymore, sir. I'm very sorry if I disturbed you, sir.
Were you awake 5 minutes ago?
No, sir.
2 minutes ago?
Not that I know of, sir.
Be sure, be sure!
All right then, I'm sure.
All right then. If you're sure, I'm sure. Of course, I was only trying to frighten you all along, my dear. You're a brave boy, Oliver. A brave boy. Did you see any of the pretty things?
Yes, sir.
Oh, they're mine, Oliver. My little property. All I've got to live on in my old age. It's a terrible thing. Old age.
Do you think I could get up now, sir?
Certainly, my boy. You can go out and have a wash.
But I had a wash yesterday.
Well, today's your birthday. Wash!
Pockets left undone are many eyes. take good care of it, that we get our share of it, and we don't mean bad. If you don't mind, if you like a lumping, it's the fine life, it's the fine.
There's a sound of tea sipping and eating crumpets. It's the fine life,
it's the fine. Mine's a fine, fine life.
Who is this,
Fagan?
Oh, ladies, I forgot to introduce you to our new lodger, Mr. Oliver Twist, Esquire. Nancy and Bet.
Charmed to meet you.
Oh, yes, we're all ladies and gentlemen around here. We're all quality.
You were no quality of your sort, none of you. Bet Dodge, have you seen the way them quality gentlemen treat their ladies?
Of course I am.
Shall we tell them how it's done?
Right here.
Go on, Nancy, give us a free show on the stage.
Go on. Yeah. 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 Come on then, Dodge, start bowing the next song.
And doodle at your petticoats, dongle in the mud, my darling.
I'll go last.
Now I'll go last.
Thank you.
somewhere. And believe you me, you couldn't make a finer start. Good luck on your first job. I'll be waiting for you here when you come back.
You can go, but be back soon. You can go, but while you're working, this place a pacing round until you're home. Safe and sound and fairly well, but be back soon. Who can tell where danger's lurking? Do not forget this tune. Be back soon. You can go, but bring back plenty of pork and cheese. And you should be clever at ease. Work as quick as back soon. There's a sixpence here for 20. Ain't that a lovely tune? Be back soon.
Our pockets are full down, watch our gold and joins upon the hour.
Back soon, I don't know somehow I miss ya. I love you, that's for my eyes. Cheerio, not goodbye. Don't be gone, don't be back soon. Give me one long last of bless ya. Remember our old tune. Be back soon.
We must be here, we'll be back here today, perhaps tomorrow. We miss you too, example to not parting from tomorrow. And we will. Gumstreet, she left her feeder, then lead her along. What's the girl?
tremble when they hear it. They've got causing after fear. It's much blacker than they fear. Nobody mentions my name. Rich men pull their piper notes outside me, empty in their coats. Now they know I can tear their throats out just to live up to my name. With me, Jenny in the end, Lenny's the man who dares stop me taking what I make. He can start to say his prayers. Four cents, large in orange, get a fix for doing all the murder. If I just much as a last bloke gave a whisper my name, Bill Sykes. Strong men tremble when they hear it. They've got cause enough to fear it. It's much blacker than they fear it. Nobody mentions my name. Some top slumming with his valet bumped into me in the alley. Now his father'll never tell. He'd never heard of my name. One bloke used to boast the claim he could take my name in vain. Poor bloke, shame he lost the green, never was he seen again. What's bad? What's the good of turning in hell? I'll be there and burning me while think of what a man is. All on account of my name. What is it? What is it? What is it? My
oh, yes, he does.
Thank you.
up. I think we'll find a great improvement in the boy.
That time for me to decide.
Thank you, Mrs. Davis. How do you feel today, my boy?
Much better, thank you, sir. May I stay here always, sir?
If you wish, dear boy, if you wish. Now, here's the doctor to see you.
You are getting better, are you not?
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yes, I know you are. You're hungry too, aren't you?
No, sir.
No, I know you're not.
He's not hungry, Mrs. Bedwin. You feel sleepy, don't you?
No, sir.
No, you're not sleepy. Not thirsty, are you?
If that boy's thirsty, I'll eat my head.
Are you?
Yes, sir. Rather
just
thirsty.
As I expected.
It's very natural he should be thirsty.
You may give him a little tea.
May I go out now, sir?
I think you may. And take a little fresh air. Don't keep him too warm, Mrs. Bedwin, but be careful he doesn't get too cold.
Would you mother goodness? You'll be glad to be out and about again, Oliver.
Doctor, did you notice the most extraordinary likeness between the boy's face and the portrait of my daughter, Agnes?
Can't say I do. I only know two sorts of boys. Mealy-faced boys and beef-faced boys.
And which is Oliver?
Mealy. Where did he come from?
Didn't I tell you? He was arrested for stealing my pocket handkerchief.
What, sir?
It was all a mistake. And when the shopkeeper told us what really happened, and he was released by the magistrate, I brought him here to make what amends I could. But I must admit, I find myself strangely attached to the child.
Why is he deceiving you, my good friend? He has had a fever. What of that? Fevers are not the duty of the good people, are they? Bad people have fevers sometimes, haven't they? He stole your pocket handkerchief, didn't he? Then he'll steal more, sir.
He didn't. Yes, what is it? Ah, yes, thank you. Now I have some other books over here. Hey, come back. Wait a moment. Oh, dear, he's gone. And I particularly wish some books to be returned today.
Send Oliver, Wicker. He'll be sure to deliver them safely, you know. If he does, I'll eat my head, sir.
Yes, do let me take them for you, please, sir.
Oh, very well, dear boy, if you wish you shall. Now, here's what I want you to do. Take these books and say you've come to pay the £4.10 that Mr. Brown owes. Here's £5. No need to rush, it's only down the road, but I shall expect you back in 10 minutes.
Very good, sir.
Now, let us see, Mrs. Bedwin. 10 minutes.
Come on, hand over.
This is
Hardly fair, Bill.
Fair enough, fair. Hardly fair, is it, Nancy? Do you think Nancy and me's got nothing better to do with our precious time but to spend it chasing after young kids? Give it here, you avaricious old skeletons. Give it here. That's for our share of the trouble. Not half enough, neither. Here. Start a library.
You can't keep the books. They belong to Mr. Brownlow. And if he finds out you've got them, he'll be out here after you.
So? He'll be out here, will he? Just what did you tell him about us?
Nothing.
That remains to be seen. But if we find you said anything, anything out of place, Fagan, I'll wager that young scoundrel's told him everything.
Help! Help! Help!
Stand off me or I'll split your head against the wall.
I don't care, but I'll build a tall stump yonder unless you kill me first.
Shanty, I'll send you that if you don't keep off.
All right, Miss Gotham, what's the matter?
The girl's gone mad, I think.
No, she hasn't. Don't you think it's fine?
Then keep quiet with
you. No, I won't keep quiet.
Oh, Miss Byron,
trying to run away with you.
I'll see you something. You've got me and what more with you have. Help me.
Or I'll put my mark in something and not care for the consequences.
Why, Nancy, you're wonderful today. Such time, what an actress.
Oh, my, take care. I'll get over anyway.
Come on, I'll put my finger in something to you.
Help.
I don't care what I am with you.
Help. You? Do you know who you are and what you are?
Oh, yes, I know all about it. Who I am and what I am.
Well, then, keep quiet with her, or I'll quiet you for a good long time to come. You're a nice one, come all this humane and genteel rubbish. A pretty subject for the child, as he calls make a friend of.
Lord help me, I am. And I wish I'd been stuck down the street before I let down to bring him here. Today he's a thief, a liar, and everything else bad from this day forth. Isn't that enough for you without beating him to death?
Come, come, Bill, we must have to the word, Bill.
Right. Yes, you deserve them from me, all right. I'll teach for you when I was a child, and I'll be made. And for 12 years, don't you forget it.
Well, if you have, it's your living.
From living.
What you deserve, you get.
No getting more giving.
Must be murdered, yes. There'll be murders, there'll be terror, such as you've never seen.
Your violence.
What did Nancy make? No error, there ain't no in between. In life. Keeping the angels waiting. It's a fine life.
Come, better do as you are told. Bill's got a heart of gold.
What a job to mess with the fetch of all God's business so far.
The gaster of Bill. The gaster in Dodger. And all in the cost of myself. Joking apart, hasn't he? And oh, I'd be the first one to say that I wasn't the same. I'm finding it hard to be really as black as they paint. I'm reviewing the situation. Can a fellow be a villain all his life? All the trials and tribulations. Better settle down and get myself a wife. And the wife could cook and sew for me and come for me and go for me and go for me and nag at me. The finger she would wag at me. The money she would take from me. The misery she'd make from me. I think I'd better think it out again.
Thank you.
life you can keep anyway. I'd rather sleep anyway. Left without anyone in the world, and I'm starting from now. So how to win friends and to influence people? So how? The situation, I must quickly look up everyone I know. Titan people, who in the station? Who can help me make a real impressive show? I will own the sweetest claridges and run a fleet of carriages and wave at all the duchesses with friendliness as much as is the speaking of my new estate. Good morrow to you, magistrate. I think I'd better think it out again. So, where shall I go? Somebody! Who do I know? Nobody. Left without anyone in the world, and I'm starting from now. So how to win friends and to influence people? So how? The situation. If you want to eat, you've got to earn a bob. Is it such a humiliation for a robot to perform an honest job? So a job I'm getting possibly. I wonder who my boss will be. I wonder if he'll take to me. What bonuses he'll make to me. I start at 8 and finish late at normal rate and normal weight. I think I'd better think it out again. What happens when I'm 17? Must come a time, 17, when you're old and it's cold, and who cares if you live or you die? Your one consolation's the money you may have put by. I'm a burden and a burden I shall stay. You'll be seeing no transformation, but it's wrong to be a rogue in every way. I don't want nobody hot for me or made to do the dirt for me. This rotten life is not for me. It's getting far too hot for me. Don't want no one to rot for me. But who will find a job for me? There is no in between for me. But who will change the scene for me? I think I'd better think it up again. Hey!
Marriage! And 2 weeks ago tomorrow it was done. It seems an age. I sold myself for 6 teaspoons, a sugar tongs, and a milk pot, with a small quantity of second-hand furniture, and some £20 cash. I went very reasonable. Cheap! Dirt cheap!
Gee! You would have been dear at any price, and dear enough I paid for you. The Lord above knows that. Well, are you going to sit there snoring all day?
I shall sit here as long as I think proper. And although I was not snoring, I shall snore, gape, sneeze, laugh, or cry as the humor strikes me. Such being my prerogative.
Your prerogative?
I wish you was, poor man.
You are, Doctor.
Drive away, madam. Drive away. The exercise of the lungs, help the eyes, soften the temper, wash the face. So drive away.
Murder? But where is Oliver? Where is this Fagan?
I can't tell you. I just wanted you to know he's safe. I must go now.
But what can I do about this? Why must you go back? What is the reason you can't tell me where he is? And why do you have to return to those people? I can call the Bow Street runners in a moment. And if you tell them what you've just told me, they'll see you come to no harm.
Don't you understand? I must go back. I want to go back. Oh, how can I explain? Back there is a man that I just can't leave. You see, I love him. You don't know what it's like to love someone like that.
I understand.
My dear ladies, do excuse me, but I am anxious about Oliver. Now, how can you help me?
I won't tell you where he is, but I'll bring it to you. Not here, that's too dangerous. Do you promise that I won't be watched? I'll follow.
I promise you, solemnly.
Then tonight, between 11 and the time the clock strikes 12, I'll go walk on London Bridge and bring Oliver.
Thank you.
came here to meet this poor creature. And as I crossed the bridge, I saw someone rapidly disappearing in the other direction.
Can you tell me what he looked like?
He was a broad-shouldered, heavily built man.
Anything else?
He wore a green coat and a tall hat.
It's Nancy! It's Private Nancy! Private Nancy!
Stop staring at him! Stand back! Or I'll kill the boy!
Somebody change, it's possible. Maybe it's strange, but it's possible. All my bosom companions and treasures I've left them behind. I'll turn a leaf over, and who can tell what I may find?
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is the only place there's room, I think, in this hall tonight. It is my pleasant function to welcome you all here tonight to say we are very pleased to see you. And a particular word of welcome, I think, to members of our traditional last night audience, the parents and families of the cast. And I think you can be very pleased and proud of the performance your sons and daughters have put on tonight. I would like to thank very briefly a number of people. I would like to thank all the students whom you didn't see, those who spent long weeks painting and making sets and moving scenery, setting programs and getting the hall ready for the show. They have all played a major part in the success of the show. I would like to thank also the teachers who performed many different tasks that go to make up a school show, programs, costumes, all of those things, getting everything ready and getting everything in good order. Without them, no show would go ahead and would run successfully. I would, of course, most like to thank and to congratulate the members of the cast on their marvellous performance tonight, and the teachers who were most involved with them, who prepared the music, and the producer, director of the show. I would also like to thank a group of people who contribute very much to the enjoyment of all our shows here. Some who have been coming for many years and some who are coming for not quite so many years, but have combined to form a major part of the enjoyment of an opera, that is, the members of the orchestra. And finally, I would like to thank a group of people whom I hope you can see, because they have gone to prepare a cup of tea and a bun and a biscuit for you. And I would like to invite you to join them in the college dining room now for a cup of tea. And may I wish you a safe journey home and a happy Christmas. Thank you very much.